Hi guys, today I'm going to be showing you how to cut a synthetic wig. Alright, so I want to come on here today and I wanted to show you guys how I cut my synthetic wigs. So there's a lot of reasons why you would need to cut or want to cut a synthetic wig. One of those reasons being because maybe the ends are just kind of damaged from wear and you want to give it a fresh kind of cut at the end, just get rid of any of that fraying that you just can't really fix anymore. Another reason would just be because maybe you get a wig in and you really love the color of it and the style of it, but maybe it's just a little bit too long for you and you wanna just trim some of the hair at the ends of it, or you wanna kind of make it less bulky by getting rid of the ends of it. And that's kind of what we're gonna be doing today. So before we get started, I wanted to remind you guys, if you are new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, make sure you hit that notification bell to get notifications on all the videos I do in the future, and give me a like, I'd really appreciate it. That's pretty much it. So now we can go ahead and get into the fun stuff and cut this wig. So to cut a wig, it's really very similar to cutting hair, which I am not a hairdresser by any means, so I'm really gonna show you how you can do this at home with like no hair cutting knowledge, because I feel like a lot of the videos I see on YouTube when it comes to cutting wigs are usually done by professionals, which is totally awesome, but they might use words and go through techniques and things like that that normal people like me and you might not really understand and can be a little overwhelming and a little hard to follow. So I just really wanted to go ahead and show you guys how I cut my wigs when I need to cut them. And I'm gonna try to make it as simple and easy to follow as possible. There's only a couple things you're gonna need to do this. One being either whatever kind of hair cutting shears you wanna use. I'm actually gonna be using fabric shears. So I'm gonna be using these, but you can get hair cutting shears. There's a little set that I use, which I'll link down below for you guys, and it's gonna have both the things that I'm using in this video in it. The other thing that you're gonna want is like thinning comb. It actually has a blade in it here, and I use it to kind of soften up the edges. I'll show you guys later on in the video. And then you're gonna wanna have clips or something just so we can use to part and section off the hair, because we're gonna be working in sections. So this is it. Most of the stuff, or all of the stuff, you might already have at home. If not, like I said, really easy to find on Amazon, very cheap, and you can use this over and over again, so you'll be set. I love this wig, but she has a lot of wear on her. I'm gonna be kind of transforming her into a new wig over the next couple weeks anyway. There's some stuff I wanna do to her, but the first thing I wanna do before I do that is I wanna get rid of all of this layer right here. So I'm pretty much cutting her to this first layer that she has to make her this length. So she can be like a medium wig length. With synthetic wigs, I kind of recommend looking to see where your first kind of layer starts and using that as your guideline for the length that you want to go. If it doesn't have layers, then obviously you kind of have to decide where you want to start cutting. But I can very clearly see where this layer starts. So this is where I'm gonna cut to. And the first thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna do your initial cut, which is the scariest part. But I'm gonna go ahead and find this first layer that I wanna cut to, and then I'm just gonna put that hair tie right where that's at. I usually just bring it down just a tiny little bit below because I'm gonna go ahead and kind of blend it in. So I've got this on here and I'm just gonna put all of that hair into this hair tie. And you just wanna make sure it's nice and tight on there so it doesn't slip or move when you're doing the cutting, because then you're gonna have different lengths. And then, so now that I have this here, and a good way to check is just to pull that first layer out and just make sure if that first layer is in the hair tie, that means that you have it too short. It's always better to go a little bit lower and work your way up to that first layer versus cutting it too short, and then you're gonna have to cut your first layer and the wig's gonna slowly get shorter and shorter because you're gonna have to keep meeting it and it's just gonna cause you problems. So I would always just say, put that hair tie on there and then just move it down just a little centimeter lower than you have it initially. And then we're gonna be cutting right underneath the hair tie. So that's also gonna give you a little tiny bit of extra length as well. And I always recommend kind of spreading the hair out when you do this. I'm just gonna show you. I like to kind of fan the hair out just because it'll make it easier for you to get your scissors through it. If you try to do this in a big, huge chunk, it's not gonna work very well. We're gonna go ahead and cut this real quick. And this is that initial cut that just kind of gets rid of all that hair for you. And then I'll show you guys how I kind of trim it and blend it in so that it matches the rest of the hair. All right, so now we have that hair gone. So it's about three and a half inches. And then I'm gonna pull that hair tie back out. First, what I'm gonna do is just make sure I've got this all even. Sometimes if it's a, you know, thicker wig, it can be a little bit more dicey. And don't worry too, like if you see like bumps and ridges, that's okay. We're gonna go ahead and go in and soften this up. So it's gonna look very blunt when you first pull it out, and that's fine. So now we have the length gone and we have it pretty much to that first layer, which is this right here. All this was my first layer. So it's a little bit longer, but not too much. Go ahead and take either your thinning shears or your little blade. And I'm literally just gonna kind of brush this through the ends. Usually I will start at about an inch above where I made the cut. And then I'm just gonna kind of take this and I'm gonna run it through just to kind of take some of the bulk out so it kind of tapers off and also blends into that layer. And you can kind of do this in sections if you want. This part doesn't have to be, you know, crazy precise, which is kind of why I also like this thing. Just like I said, I start at about an inch above where I cut, and I'm just gonna take care with this until I feel like it looks blended, it looks a little softer, and it looks like it's kind of part of the wig and not separate anymore. And up in the front, if you want to come a little higher so that you have a little bit more a little bit more of that thinning in the front, you can absolutely do that too. You can come about an inch and a half up and just kind of get that so that it's not so bulky at the end. And we're just kind of thinning her out as well, which also helps a ton if you're trying to do this to kind of debulk a wig. Thinning out the ends like this is gonna make a huge difference in how she looks and how much lighter she's gonna feel. So like this section right here is pretty good. It's nice, it's thin, it's not like a big blunt area, and it kind of blends into those other layers. And you can also, if you want, you can take it and you can kind of, you know, work layer by layer. So if you want to section it off, you can. I probably should do it like that just to show you guys. It's a little bit easier sometimes, especially if you're working with a thicker wig, if you work it in smaller sections like this. I kind of find that I like to have the whole hair down when I first do this initially, just because I can really make sure it's blending all together. Whereas if you do it in sections like this, sometimes as you start to bring the hair down, you realize that maybe it's not blended together as well as you'd like, but then you can always run your shears back through it. Something else, a little tip I will mention to you, if you're trying to get rid of some of the bulk of your wig and thin out a wig that's a little bit higher density, on these lower layers, I wouldn't recommend it on the top layer, but on these lower layers, you can take this razor and start, you know, pretty much halfway up and kind of run it through, and it's gonna take some of that hair off and that bulk off, and it's gonna help thin out your wig. I just wanted to mention that. We're not really doing a thinning a wig video, but I just wanted to let you guys know because I am doing that right now, and you're gonna see that in the speed up. So if anybody asks what I'm doing, that's why you see me running it up a little bit higher on this bottom layer, because I just wanna give her a little bit less density by just kind of getting rid of some of this hair. I'm gonna go ahead and go through and do the rest of this wig, and then we'll come back and I'll show you just kind of the final touches that I like to do just to make sure everything's nice and even and looks good. And that's really it. It's a really quick, easy thing. It's a little intimidating because obviously anytime you take scissors to your wig, you're gonna get a little scared, but I promise you it's super easy. Anybody can do it. Just, you have to take the first step and take that first cut. Hold your breath if you need to, and then I promise you it'll be fine. All right, so now that we've gone through and we've cut her, I really didn't do any trimming or anything to her top layer because she's already the length that I want her. And then this is kind of the final result for the most part. The next thing you're gonna wanna do is just kind of go around and just make sure everything looks like it's the same length. You can just take the hair if you wanna make sure that everything's the same length and just pull from either side forward like this and just check and see. And if you see something that's like a little bit longer, you can trim it like that. But that's just kind of how I check to see if it's okay. And then you can get rid of any other bulk that you kind of see that you feel like you need to get rid of now that you have the whole wig down. So the last thing that I recommend doing once you're done cutting your ends and everything is, now that we've kind of cut the ends and we've taken something to them and kind of, you know, bladed them and kind of, you know, thin them out, we don't want the hair at the ends to start fraying and splitting up, you know, up the root, which happens, which is very similar to what happens to human hair as well, but it happens with synthetic hair too. And I get asked a lot, like people be like, oh, I just trimmed my wig and now I wore her once and now she feels like super frayed and she's matting up. And that's because they did not do this next step. So what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna take a little heat to the ends of this wig. This obviously is a lot easier to do if it's not curly, but you're just gonna wanna really just hit those ends, and we're essentially kind of sealing and repairing the damage that we kind of just did with our razor blade. So you're just gonna take this right at the end so that, you know, not even an inch, and just run your heat, just say medium heat. It doesn't have to be anything crazy high. Just normally like the same heat you would use to kind of repair the ends of a wig or straighten your wig in that like 300 range. I wouldn't go any higher than 300, you don't need to. And you're just gonna kind of hit those ends with the heat, and you're gonna see a big difference because you're gonna see it kind of soften up. Right now on the one side, it looks a little bit more frayed and kind of, you can see kind of like that little splitting happening. And then once you go through here, you're gonna feel it. It's gonna feel so much softer and so much smoother. And that's really gonna tell you that you really got those ends. So you just wanna make sure you get the ends really well, all the way through the wig, wherever you cut. And that's gonna kind of help seal the ends of the wig. So it also helps you just kind of really see like what you did, if you have anything that like looks a little crazy or longer than the rest of it or whatever. But this is really just gonna kind of help seal those ends, make them look soft, feel soft again, and all of that. So now we should be good. This is kind of where I take my final last little look to make sure that everything is good. I like to make sure the wig is on my wig head straight and where I want it to be, so I can really just check my lengths, make sure all my lengths are good to go, which it looks like they are. And like I said too, I'll kind of just take a couple pieces, one from each side, and just bring them next to each other to see how we're looking. And I think we're good. So this is kind of the final result. So that's really it. It's super, super easy, guys. I hope this was easy to follow. It's nothing crazy. It really is just more of getting over the fear of taking scissors to your wig, because I know that's always scary, especially if you're not professional. You can call around if you want to see if there's a salon that will alter wigs for you, cut wigs for you. It's just, I wear synthetic wigs and none of my wigs cost more than like $100. So I really don't see the point in going and spending more money to have a stylist go in and cut it. So I've just kind of figured out how to do it myself. But I hope this was easy to follow. I hope this was helpful for you guys. If you have any questions, let me know in the comments below. If you have any other tips or tricks when it comes to cutting your hair, also let me know that, because I always love to, you know, find new ways and try new ways of doing things. If you guys are new to my channel, like I said before, don't forget to subscribe. We're gonna be doing a huge wig giveaway when we hit 5,000 subscribers. That's our goal for this year. Make sure you hit the notification bell so you get notifications on all the videos I do in the future. And give me a like if you found this useful. I'd really appreciate it. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you on the next video.